In this lesson, we will derive the conservation of linear momentum equation for control volumes. Linear momentum is the product of mass and velocity. This means that the linear momentum of a fluid stream will change if its direction, speed, or velocity profile changes due to external forces. Many engineering-related devices are designed to alter the momentum of fluid streams to produce desirable effects. For example, airplane wings are designed to divert airflow to produce lift, and a jet engine accelerates exhaust gases to produce thrust. Here we have a mass shaded in pink, with a certain momentum, mv. We will call this mass our system. Various external forces are acting on the system. The conservation of linear momentum equation for a system states that the time rate of change of a system's linear momentum, dmv dt, is equal to the sum of external forces acting on the system. Here we use capital D's for the time derivative to indicate that we are taking the system point of view. Let's say a control volume is coincident with the system at this moment in time. The control surface surrounds the control volume and is marked by the red dashed lines. At this time, the external forces on the system are the same as the external forces on the control volume because they happen to occupy the same region of space. We now apply the Reynolds transport theorem with the linear momentum as the extensive property capital B and the velocity as the corresponding intensive quantity lowercase b. Substitute the expressions for capital B and lowercase b into the Reynolds transport theorem. The left side of the equation is the time rate of change of the linear momentum of the system, which we have previously stated is equal to the sum of the external forces acting on the system. Furthermore, this is equal to the sum of the external forces acting on the control volume. We now have the general conservation of linear momentum equation for a control volume. The equation states that the time rate of change of linear momentum in the control volume plus the net flux of linear momentum through the control surface due to mass flow is equal to the sum of the external forces acting on the control volume. This equation is valid for control volumes that are fixed and rigid, moving at a constant velocity, and/or deforming. There are many types of external forces that can act on a control volume. Here we have a pipe filled with a flowing fluid that is supported by a post. The control surface is marked by red dashed lines. Some common forces that you will encounter when solving linear momentum problems are body forces such as weight, and surface forces such as pressure forces, frictional or viscous forces, and reaction or anchoring forces. The conservation of linear momentum equation is a vector equation. The left side of the equation contains velocity vectors, which have three components. The x component is lowercase u, the y component is lowercase v, and the z component is lowercase w. The right side of the equation contains the sum of the external forces, which also has three components. The sum of the x components of the forces, the sum of the y components of the forces, and the sum of the z components of the forces. We plug in these vectors into the conservation of linear momentum equation and equate the x components, y components, and z components. And our single vector equation has become three scalar equations. In their current form, the conservation of momentum equations can be difficult to utilize. We will now examine a common situation which will greatly simplify these equations. Here we have fluid flowing steadily through a generic device which has multiple inlets and outlets and does not deform. The device is surrounded by a control surface which is marked by red dashed lines, and the control volume is contained inside the control surface. The direction of flow is indicated by blue velocity vectors. The inlets are labeled 1 and 2, while the outlets are labeled 3 and 4. The direction of the normal vectors are shown in orange and point outward from the control surface. We start with the vector form of the conservation of linear momentum equation for control volumes. Since the flow is steady, the term with the time derivative is equal to 0, indicating that the linear momentum in the control volume is constant in time. Also, since the control surface does not deform, we can remove the time dependence from the limits of integration. Notice that the remaining integral is over the entire control surface. We can break up the control surface into multiple sections and integrate over each of these sections individually. The first integral will cover the area for inlet 1. The second integral will cover the area for inlet 2. The third integral will cover the area for outlet 3. And the fourth integral will cover the area for outlet 4. We also need a fifth integral to cover the walls of the device. The dot products can be simplified by noticing that the angle between the velocity vector and normal vectors are parallel at the inlets and outlets. Recall that the dot product of any two vectors can be calculated by multiplying the magnitude of the two vectors by the cosine of the angle between them. For the inlets, the angle between the velocity vector and normal vector is 180 degrees, which means the dot products in integrals 1 and 2 become negative v. For the outlets, the angle between the velocity vector and normal vector is 0 degrees, which means the dot products in integrals 3 and 4 become positive v. The no-slip boundary condition means the velocity at every wall is 0. We now have four integrals with integrands consisting of the velocity vector v times density rho times speed v times area dA. In order to evaluate these integrals, we would need to know the velocity profiles at each inlet and outlet. On the right, we have an arbitrary inlet or outlet. There are a few possible velocity profiles that could occur. If the flow is very slow, or the diameter is very small, or the fluid viscosity is very high, the velocity profile may look parabolic, a condition known as laminar flow. The velocity is zero at the walls and reaches a maximum value at the center. Most flows are turbulent and have a velocity profile that appears flatter at the center and drops to zero rapidly at the walls. In specific circumstances, the velocity profile will appear almost completely flat and uniform. In order to simplify the integral, we make a couple of assumptions. First, we replace the actual velocity profile with an average velocity, V average, that produces the same mass flow rate as the actual profile. Next, we assume that the density is uniform over the entire cross-sectional area. Since both the velocity and density are assumed constant over the cross-section, we can pull them out of the integral, and the integral of dA is simply the area A. Rho times V average times A is the mass flux m dot. The assumption of uniform velocity and density have allowed us to convert the integral into a simple algebraic expression, the average velocity vector times m dot, which has units of momentum per time. However, if we had evaluated the integral using the actual velocity profile, we would find that the expression V average times m dot produces some error, requiring us to introduce a momentum flux correction factor, beta. Beta is a measure of how much the momentum flux for the actual flow deviates from the momentum flux calculated using the uniform velocity profile assumption. For the parabolic laminar flow on the right, the value of beta is 4/3. For the flatter turbulent flow in the middle, the value of beta is typically between 1.01 and 1.04. For the uniform flow on the left, beta is exactly 1. Returning to the generic device, we replace the inlet and outlet integrals with beta times m dot times the average velocity vector. Notice that a negative sign appears in front of the inlet terms and a positive sign appears in front of the outlet terms. We can express this equation more compactly by rewriting it as the sum of beta m dot v average at the outlets minus the sum of beta m dot v average at the inlets. We will now drop the J subscript to make the equation look cleaner. Recall that the conservation of linear momentum equation for steady flow tells us that the integral over the entire control surface is equal to the sum of external forces on the control volume. We can break up this vector equation into its x, y, and z components. The velocity vector v average is lowercase u average I hat plus lowercase v average j hat plus lowercase w average k hat. The sum of the external force vectors is the sum of the x component of the forces, I hat, plus the sum of the y component of the forces, j hat, plus the sum of the z component of the forces, k hat. We can plug in the expressions for velocity vector and sum of external forces into the conservation of linear momentum equation, and separate the resulting equation into x components, y components, and z components. This allows us to obtain an equation for the conservation of linear momentum in the x direction, y direction, and z direction. Notice that the component of the average velocity changes in each equation. Lowercase u average appears in the equation for the x direction, lowercase v average appears in the equation for the y direction, and lowercase w average appears in the equation for the z direction. When calculating m dot, remember to use the total speed v average, not a component of the velocity. Additionally, it's important to remember that the components of the velocity, as well as the total speed v average, are the flow speeds relative to the control volume. As discussed earlier, for turbulent flows, the correction factor beta is approximately equal to 1, and for uniform flows, beta is exactly 1. Since most real flows are turbulent, it is common to set beta equal to 1 in the conservation of linear momentum equations. For the x direction, the sum of m dot times lowercase u average for the outlets minus the sum of m dot times lowercase u average for the inlets equals the sum of the x components of the external forces on the control volume. For the y direction, the sum of m dot times lowercase v average for the outlets minus the sum of m dot times lowercase v average for the inlets equals the sum of the y components of the external forces on the control volume. For the z direction, the sum of m dot times lowercase w average for the outlets minus the sum of m dot times lowercase w average for the inlets equals the sum of the z components of the external forces on the control volume. Many devices, such as pumps, turbines, valves, pipes, and so on, only have one inlet and one outlet. Since we are examining steady flow conditions, the mass flow rate at the inlet is equal to the mass flow rate at the outlet, which we will call m dot. The left side of the conservation of linear momentum equation simplify to m dot times the velocity component at the outlet minus the velocity component at the inlet.